Hey y'all, so I'm back with another video. Oh my god, it's been so long since I've done a tutorial. I actually did a very glam makeup look for IMATS Atlanta and I decided to film it. So here I am with my bonnet because my hair was just done the day before. I'm placing some warm toned eyeshadows on my crease and my crease transition because I'm doing a black lip and I want to keep the eyes warm, keep the cheeks warm because sometimes when you go really dark on the lips, it can really wash you out. So I'm using some Inglot eyeshadows. I was trying to shop my stash and use some colors I haven't used in a while. So these are some like cranberry shades. So the whole key to getting a really diffused look is applying it with blender brushes. Don't use like stiff packer eyeshadow brushes. Build the color with a blender. So that's pretty much it. Like now all I'm doing is adding a nude color to my lid because I'm going to have a black wing and I know that, you know, I just wanted to kind of keep it simple on the eyes. So this is a black eyeshadow from Saucebox Cosmetics. And it's a really good one. It's one of those that you can actually use it as a liner if you want. I'm using it to gently smoke out my outer V really, really lightly just because I want a little bit more dimension to the look. So, you know, it's all about contouring the eye, shaping it. When I do this little triangle, it actually extends my eyes, making them look bigger and more cat-eyed. So again, applying it with a blending brush in order to diffuse it. And to soften it even more, I'm going back in with that blender that has a little bit of that cranberry shadow on it. And this is going to kind of melt it into the rest of the look. I'm using my favorite gel liner of all time, which is Inglot number 77, an AMC gel liner, and a teeny, really precise Delium Tools brush because this is going to give me a really nice wing. And as you can see, the brush head is really small and precise, so I can get that little cut. So I'm drawing in a wing. I'd start by doing the outside, and then I just connect it to the front. And by doing it that way, I'm ensuring symmetry on both sides. So, yeah. You might have noticed that I leave most of the wrapper on the Inglot gel liner in order to prevent it from drying. Alright, so now I'm applying some lashes. These are probably from Lady Moss Beauty, their Cocoa Lashes. I also off-camera applied some black Urban Decay Perversion liner to my waterline. And I'm taking another angle brush and I'm kind of like cleaning up that waterline and dragging the black in my inner corner just add a little bit because it's just about these little details that kind of make it so fun without going like super heavy or super overboard. So I'm just detailing out the liner, making sure it's nice and neat. And then I'm adding mascara to blend my real lashes in with my falsies. This is the new Dry Bar Mascara from IT Cosmetics. And then lastly, I'm taking my individual lash color from Alcone. And I'm squeezing my falsies and real lashes together so they have a nice amount of lift and they feel nice and comfortable. This is something I like to do when I'm not wearing a lot of eyeshadow and this makes my lash line look super thick and it kind of blends everything together. I'm tight lining using a Pixie. It's actually a tight liner pencil. Like, it's kind of genius. It's really small so it fits into those tight areas. And that's it with the eye. So you can see it's more about the liner and it's like a really soft shadow. This is my Eve Pearl Salmon Concealer, Holy Grail. I don't get a lot of sleep. I'm a lot more tired now that I'm a mom. So it shows under my eyes. So I'm applying that underneath my eyes. And now I'm applying, this is NARS Sheer Glow Foundation in Syracuse. I like to apply it all over my face with my finger so I don't waste it. It doesn't get absorbed into a brush or a sponge. And then I'm using the Sephora Airbrush Foundation Brush and I'm just buffing it in. I really love this foundation. I'm running low on it, but I love the color. I love the finish. And when I do big makeup events like IMATS, I really make sure that my whole face is done. You know, like I take time to do eyes, face, lips, like I don't leave anything out. So I'm going in now with that foundation around my brows because I have freshly microbladed brows here. I'm not touching them at all. So I use a teeny concealer brush so that way I don't accidentally get foundation on them. And that's also why I kind of skip excessive eyeshadow. So this is IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer. I had it for a while and I wasn't really using it. And then the last like 6 months, I really love it now. Like, it's very full coverage, but not cakey. And as you can see, it really gives a nice little brightening effect to the eye. You don't need a lot. I just put a few little dots. And it really covers. So I put it on with a synthetic blender brush, and then I dab it in with a beauty blender. I actually don't really use beauty blenders all the time, but if I want a really flawless finish, like, I'll take the time to go in with that second blend. So now I'm actually setting it with Laura Mercier translucent powder mixed with their glow powder. That's my new winning combo. I use a same damp beauty blender because my skin is so dry right now that the damp beauty blender prevents it from looking cakey and dry. So I really focus the powder onto the areas that crease, which are underneath the eyes, and where I want to brighten, which is like the center of the face, like the chin, middle of the forehead, down the center of the nose. And then what I do is I take a more fluffy brush and I lightly dust powder everywhere else to set it, because I knew I was going to have a long day and I don't need a lot, but just a little bit. Alright, time to contour those cheeks. I'm coming in with a bronzy tone in my FB09 from Sedona Lace, my domed contour brush. This is what I use literally like every single day for my highlight and contour, actually my contour. And then I use this old school Low Carnell paintbrush. Y'all remember those brushes back in the day? This is like such an easy brush to do nose contour. It's large, it's got enough shape but fluffiness to it where it's just like a real quick snatch. So I'm using my IT Cosmetics sculpting kit. People don't ever talk about it, but I actually really like the kit. It has really good colors. And then I like to kind of go in with the highlight just to make sure everything's nice and clean on the bridge. Now I'm applying a warm tone blush to my cheeks because, again, when you go dark with a lipstick, which I'm about to do in a minute, you want to keep the color on your face, some extra bronzer, some extra blush, whatever you need. So as you can see, it's starting to bring color back to my face. And then I cut in a second time with more contour, a darker contour, just because I like the first layer of bronzer to give a soft bronzing effect, and the second amount of bronzer or contour is more of like the definition. I always do my lower lash line after I finish my concealer and my face, because I don't want to eat the blended lower lash line eyeshadow with highlight and with concealer. Alright y'all, so I'm taking that same black tight lining eyeliner from Pixie Beauty and I'm using it as a lip liner. You can honestly use black lip liners, gel liners as lipstick too. I ended up using a black liquid lipstick from Ofra, but I needed a lip liner, and they don't really sell black lip liners, but they definitely sell black eyeliners. So here's that black liquid lipstick. I actually found that this lipstick looked a little bit duller than I thought. So after applying a coat, I went over it with the black liner. I know this seems like an extreme look to wear black lipstick, but it kind of went with my dark, freshly microbladed brows. And they're dark because they are healing, so I needed something to kind of balance them out. So the black lipstick, I think, looks chic. It doesn't have to look like vampire-ish, you know, if you do it really nicely and really neat.
Okay, so here is the final look. All black on, all black makeup. My hair is fresh, brows are still microbladed. So I hope you guys enjoyed this final look. I'm going to IMAT, so I am like makeuped out. This is definitely more makeup than I normally wear. So, hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Check out makeupbyrenren.com for a full post with pictures and all that good stuff. Until next time, I hope you guys have a great night. Ciao, fellas.